Well, more now on that Virgin flight forced to make an emergency landing in New Zealand after its engine caught fire.
Michael Hayward was on board and took this video you're watching now and joins us now from Invercargill in New Zealand. Michael, good morning to you. I mean, just explain to us what happened.
Thanks for having me here. So at this point, we're taking off from Queenstown. It's 6 p.m, surrounded by mountains on all sides, so it's fairly dark outside. Apart from the lights on the runway, plane starts to take off, run, rotates, and within 10 seconds, bang. You see flames coming out the right-hand engine, some like glow in the cabin as each engine like shot hits the cabin. It's quite the experience. I mean, you don't expect it on a takeoff, and there was certainly some initial fear in the cabin because, again, this ain't right. You don't want to see fire come out the engine of the airplane, especially on takeoff.
No, it's the last thing.
Yeah, quite the experience.
And how did everyone react on board?
So there was definitely some initial panic, a few cries because people were kind of, I guess, there is a fear of flying, there is a fear of being in the air on something that's now on fire. But within a few minutes, people talking to each other, calming each other down. You could hear laugh from the back, people were joking about getting smuggled without using an airplane and never flying again. So, within 5 minutes, the mood in the cabin was fairly amicable as people kind of calmed each other down.
It might have been nervous laughter. I think if that was me, I would have been absolutely terrified, yeah. Michael, just seeing that out your window and not quite knowing what was happening, right? Was it ever explained to you? What was the communication like on board?
So communication was pretty good. And actually, I've got to say, massive thumbs up to the pilots on board, the cabin crew on board, and from Virgin Australia as well. So after we took off, 15 minutes later, we took off, pilot shot off the engine, got us to a safe altitude and held around for a little bit. The next thing to us that as it took off, control tower reported they'd seen we flew through a flock of birds, and in the end that took out one of the engines and we were now heading south towards Invercargill, where we'd make an unscheduled emergency landing. But honestly, from there, the cabin crew, again, this is just takeoff, they're still in their jump seats, they haven't had a chance to kind of stand up and do their cabin checks and things like that. But when they could, they went around, reassured everyone, secured the cabin. They were superb. And even when we got to Invercargill, Virgin Australia, very prompt on getting us into the terminal, sign out some paperwork, like contact details of, contact details so when we get a replacement flight out, and then getting us into a hotel where we stayed for the night.
When are you getting home? When are you getting back to Australia?
So the when we were on the coach yesterday heading to the hotel, they told us that there is a there is a new flight waiting for us in Queenstown. We'll leave shortly, actually, for the airport. We'll get a coach up to Queenstown, new plane, new crew, and they'll fly us over to Australia, hopefully late afternoon, late morning, early afternoon.
Jeez, you're relaxed. You're
I know,
relaxed
you really I would not be as relaxed as that. But thank you so much for joining us. Hopefully this is smooth sailing this time round, Michael. Appreciate it.
No worries. Thanks for having me.
Cheers, mate. That's good. Let's get straight to that mid-air emergency caught on camera. New video from passengers on board a Virgin Australia flight bound for Melbourne showing flames spitting from an engine.
Imagine how scary that was. Almost 70 passengers are now stranded in regional New Zealand in what is another issue for Boeing.
This morning, new video of that mid-air emergency in New Zealand. A Boeing 737 taking off from Queenstown and then... fire spitting out of an engine. One passenger on board recounting the moment things shifted.
Within 10 seconds, we just hear a loud bang within the cabin. Flames, pshum, pshum, pshum. There was an initial panic, a few cries, but that very quickly kind of dwindled down as passengers kind of reassured one another.
Flight VA148 en route to Melbourne, taking off around 6 p.m, grounded almost an hour later at Invercargill. Virgin saying the cause, a possible bird strike. No passengers or crew are believed to have been injured.
Let's go live to TVNZ One News reporter Jared McCulloch at Invercargill, where those passengers have spent the night. Jared, good morning to you. Dozens of travellers were stuck waiting on the tarmac for hours.
Yeah, that's right. They landed here about 6.50 last night here at Invercargill Airport after taking off at around 6 o'clock yesterday from Queenstown, as if you guys have described there, of that fiery bit of inferno taking off from that possible bird strike. They spent a few hours here on the tarmac, quite some time before they were picked up by buses. It was around about 9.30 last night before they were taken to a local hotel here to spend the night in the deep south. Now, we understand that the passengers this morning will head back to Queenstown. Many of them will head back to Queenstown this morning to hopefully get on another flight back to Melbourne when they are a distance to go to from there. Otherwise, yes, they've had a bit of an interesting night here in Invercargill.
Sure was, mate. Thank you so much for that. We're glad they're okay.